legs are going to kind of chat with him. You'll see how my heel kind of bumps. I'm not totally standing still quite. Yeah, a little bit left, a little bit right. Hold them together, just kind of bob. You know, just kind of relax as well as just kind of hang it. And this, along with asking him to soften down and really drop his head down around that corner and be real soft for you, it's going to teach him rhythm. So just put the eye on that left hand. Start to break and ask him for a smaller and smaller circle. His body needs to stay just the same. Your rhythm needs to stay the same. And you're just going to slowly make that circle smaller and smaller and smaller. Okay? By picking up on that left hand, using your body, kind of bumping your calves, just kind of rattle around. Just relax. Let it all just kind of hang loose. Relax. I want him to drop his
knees. There's one thing I want to ask him. Because I hold a loose rein and he always pulls it back out of my mat.
So then be clear. Be real, real clear. It's okay to close your fist. If he wants to do one of those things, let him bump against it a couple times.
Do I actually pull back on it or
no,
just let him bump?
Just hold it. Just hold it. Here, make that circle smaller and smaller. Take more left rein. Take more bend. More
now
bend.
Higher this way or more to me?
You're going to pick it up. You're going to pick it up so that your elbow, and this is how I do it when I have an inside bend. And that's a very, very good question. You're going to pick it up so that your elbow almost makes a straight line down to his nose. Okay? So down through your arm. See that there? Yep. So when I ask him, I'll show you here on the left as I turn back to the left. See how my elbow kind of runs straight down to his nose?
Okay.
That's where I'd like it to be. So, in certain instances, I'm going to pick up real high here and isolate his shoulder, but only if we're working specific. Once we start to work on circles and on rolling around, I want you to open up and I want your elbows to go down through your hand, down to his nose. So that when I ask you to turn, we're going to keep that same bend.
So how am I getting a little high? Am I getting a shorter range? Get him in a little tighter.
Draw your elbow back. Draw your elbow back. Move yourself on
shoulder a little bit. And then you'll see here how I just draw my elbow around the corner. See that?
Yeah.
And so if I come back around here, again, I'm going to keep that elbow out and draw my elbow around the corner. Okay? So when I'm up on a circle and we're cruising, I'm going to soften him up. And I'm going to ask him the same way. I'm going to try and keep that elbow straight down to his nose.
And now here you're going to come here. You're going to actually do a little bit of bumping
to keep his body shaped, right? So now we're starting off. We're working on circles. We're going to get that nice round bowl. And what I'm going to start to do is ask him to walk a circle. But once I've set my shape, I'm going to use my body to keep his ribcage figured out. Right? Remember we had a little bit of trouble with that ribcage early on?
Yeah.
Now we're going to see how bad they come loose. Because now I'm walking in a circle, but if I take my leg off, he's just going to turn right around. Okay? So as I ask him to shift his nose to me, I'm using a little bit of right leg, right here. I'm just bumping on, keeping his ribcage bent. Okay? So we're going to walk a real nice circle here. And he's real nice and soft, real nice and soft, real nice and soft. And I'm just bumping on him with this right leg just to keep him real bent. Now watch what happens if I quick bump him here on the inside. Okay? So I'm creating the balance. I'm creating the balance. You're creating the balance by getting him back into a walk, picking up on that right or left rein. Let's go left.
Oh, he's got the rein in his mouth.
And you're going to start to bump.
Oh, no, it's gone.
Come here.
Yeah, that's fine. And you're going to start to bump with that right heel. You want to push his rib cage. You want to make a nice circle so that he's on your circle. Right?
pushing out a bit, yeah.
Yeah, which I actually would like him to do. I want him to actually soften and round. So you're almost going to bend him around that inside leg. And this is part of getting him soft in the throat. Good, your elbow looks great.
Not like it should be or shouldn't be.
No, it looks great. Your elbow looks really good. Yeah, no, that's. And now as you make your circle smaller, just bring that elbow out, soften your hand, and draw it back a little bit. There you go. There you go. Continue to ball that right leg a little bit. Continue to keep him softened up so that he doesn't fall in and just turn around.
Looks good.
Down there, if I can walk him on a circle and he'll start to drop his nose and I can ask to be down around the feet of it.
Yeah, right.
I'm going to give him that space. I'm going to let him drop his head down because you know what?
Yes,
he'll go all the way down. Right? And so I'm actually going to give him a little bit of space to drop his nose.